Gedevach, everybody. So you know, the great Rebbe of Radzin, Rebbe Gershon Henoch of Radzin, he was an enekel, he was a grandson of the Ishbitzer, of Rebbe Mordechai Yosef of Ishbitzer. And so the story goes like this. You know, Rebbe Gershon Henoch was a, even as a tzaddik, as an adult, was a very fiery, confident, creative personality. And so people that are like that as adults usually start off like that as children as well. And so when you have a child who has a big neshama, like Rav Gershon Henoch, coupled with that creative, energetic, confident, changing the world type of personality, so it could sometimes, you know, become a difficult thing to manage. So the following ma'aseh we have like this, that Rav Gershon Henoch was a little kid, and he was walking in his city. And in the city of Ishbitz over there at that time, there was a little bit of a stream, like a river. And there was a narrow footbridge to cross that stream. And the size, the width of the bridge was only wide enough for one person to walk at a time. Now it happens to be that Rav Gershon Henoch, as a kid, he's trying to cross the bridge. You know, in his mazel, there's a person walking in front of him. Now the person walking in front of him on the bridge was an elderly chassid, an old chassid, and he was walking as an elderly chassid. He was walking very slowly. And so Rav Gershon Henoch is a little bit, he's getting a little bit antsy. He wants to get across. So he starts pushing to try to, you know, to get through. And so the older chassid turns around and he says, "How dare you try to push me? Do you know who I am?" And he says, "I'm an enekel of the Chayz of Lublin." That's what the old chassid said. "I'm a descendant of the Chayz of Lublin, the great seer of Lublin." So Rav Gershon Henoch, on the spot, without flinching, he says, "So what? The Chayz of Lublin is dead. My grandfather is the Rebbe, and he's alive." So that the old man hears that. He's like, "Wow, such a thing? To say the Chayz of Lublin is dead and my grandfather's alive? Such disrespect about the Chayza." So the old man, you know, I guess after crossing the bridge, the old man goes to tell on the little boy. So he goes to the Rebbe, he goes to the Ishbitzer. And he goes, knocks on the office, on the door, he goes to the Ishbitzer, and he says, "You know, I have to tell you something about your enekel, Gershon Henoch. That this is what happened on the bridge. He tried to cut me off, you know. And I tell him I'm an enekel from the Chayza." And he says, "Who cares? The Chayza is dead and my grandfather's the Rebbe. He's alive." So, you know, so the Ishbitzer is shaken up by such a thing. So he calls in his grandson and he says, "Nu, is it true that you said that?" So he said, "Yeah, I said that." So the Ishbitzer begins to shake and he says, "Such a thing, the Chayza of Lublin? The Chayza of Lublin, to say such a thing, that the Chayza is dead, to talk like that about the Chayza of Lublin, who am I compared to the Chayza? I'm amish nothing to the Chayza." So, you know, so Gershon Henoch, as a kid, he's beginning to get nervous, you know, he feels a little bit bad, maybe he's starting to cry a little bit. But after a minute or two, the Ishbitzer calms down, and the Ishbitzer says to his grandson, he says, "But the truth is, the Chayza is dead. And I am alive. And as long as I'm alive, I could be as great as Rishon Bar Yochai." That's what he said to his grandson. And so that's an amazing thing. Because of course, obviously, it goes without saying to respect Dalei Hadar. But as long as you're alive, it means that you have a spark of a divine within you. The infinite one himself is enlivening you. It means the sky's the limit. Why limit yourself to the Chayz of Lublin? You can be as great as Rishon Bar Yochai even, as long as you're alive. So the Chayza was Nifter, the Ishbitzer was Nifter. Tzaddikim of past generations are no longer here, but we're alive. And if we're alive, we have to dream and aspire to be great people, even greater than them. And if we aspire to be even greater than them, maybe we'll become the people that we have to become. No, Hashem should help us that this week should be a week full of brachas and yeshuas and potential being actualized. We should be zaycha to that personally, b'frat, u'b'chlal, u'b'yaskal tzaddik, meher v'imenu, amen.